It looks like this is what you got.
I didn't want to get Caryl a bigger bouquet of flowers than I get you, so I just settled on this quick and easy thing.
Boy, for this second and moment, you were smart.
I talked to Zach before Chris and I headed over to their house, and they actually have to go off and do an errand, so I just told them that we would just drop the muffins off at their doorstep.
Well, too bad it's kind of rainy.
I know.
I'm not sure we're going to hang out that long.
No.
Won't be too bad.
I'll just take it quick.
I don't think I probably would think about making a special trip to go see Caryl's new house. It's not something that I was excited and jumping all over the page, you know, to go do. But, you know, it's like, okay, this is what we're doing.
Very sweet of you to accommodate them. Because, you know, Amy made the point when we went over to her and Chris's place that, you know, it's important that, you know, if we ever had a family event, if you guys were doing a handoff between the grandkids, you know, she'd know where you're at.
We're cordial. I don't think there's anything weird or...
You know, Amy and I have lots of cordial conversations. But you never know which Amy's going to show up. Sometimes when Amy shows up and she's in a great place and then you say the wrong thing and whoops, you know, things go, you know, south quick, you know, really quick. If she comes and she's, you know, locked and loaded, you know, I want to have, you know, a couple of clips ready to go too.
What's the address to Caryl's house?
I've got it covered, huh?
Oh, here it is.
I've already got it going right here.
I want to know where we're going, babe.
So if I disappear, you can know where to find.
Yeah.
Poker game at Caryl's house. I'm kidding. I'm sure she doesn't play poker. Right?
Chris has that sarcastic sense of humor that a lot of times it's funny. Sometimes it's not. And so I'm just learning how to fight back.
It's amazing what a little bit of wine will do for you. Calm the nerves.
Have you had too much of that?
No, I'm not. I'm not at all. I had like three sips. You should know my emotional triggers by now.
When I'm gonna be around Amy, I think I get a little anxiety. And it's not her, it's me. It just is what it is, so.
Yeah, she's down one of these things.
That's her white car, isn't it?
I feel like the whole thing about going over to Caryl's house is like a kid who really doesn't want to do something. And they really don't know what they're getting themselves into, so they'd rather not go ahead and do it, and that's pretty much me. But we're here now, and, you know, there's no turning back. We'll just see what happens.
Are you ready for this?
I'm ready. Are you ready? That's a bigger question. Are you ready for this?
This is definitely a little bit nerve-wracking. Having your boyfriend's ex-wife and her fiance over to your house can be a little intimidating, so I think I was just slightly on edge.
Hi, guys.
Hello, Caryl.
Hi.
Happy housewarming.
Oh, isn't that sweet? Thank you.
Hey, hi. Okay. Well, what a cute little house.
She'd give you the tour, but this is it.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah. Oh, it's
no, this is cute.
I tell you, it was a good idea at the time, but then the weather changed.
I know.
But actually, at the moment, it's not raining. Should we take a quick look before it does start raining?
Yeah, and then I'll get some drinks and we'll sit and visit.
Okay, that sounds good.
Isn't it funny how close it is to Zachary's?
Yeah, that is funny. I thought that was kind of funny.
It is a little awkward that we're so close. It feels like, oh, I should probably look for a house next to Zachary, but honestly, we all live in the same neighborhood.
This whole thing was here. Matt had the idea of bringing the deck out to it so it becomes a bench.
I would never have thought of to run it right up next to the block wall, but it works.
Oh, I thought they did a good job on the deck. It was a good design, good color choice. It was done well.
So you two are cohabitating now.
It's, yeah, it's I put in a change official. Of, officially change of address
oh,
and everything, yeah.
So now for me, it will still always, you know, feel funny and different and weird. Just socializing with them and just Chris and I. Yeah, I understand the whole concept of, you know, being friends and all this stuff, but when a relationship breaks up, I think it just brings back too many memories.
Can the motorcycle and both cars fit in the garage?
No.
So that begs the next question. Whose car?
For some reason, Chris insists on it.
Okay.
I need a shop or rent a barn from somebody.
I would say it was very natural. I mean, there's always a little teeny bit of, you know, like, oh, I wonder, you know, who's going to blow a gasket.
Why don't you guys, okay, it's kind of cold. Do you guys want to sit in the house?
Sure.
Have a seat. Move the pillows around. You don't have to sit.
Oh, no, this is
you
good.
You guys take the couch so you have more room.
No, this is good.
Okay.
What are you drinking?
I'm having wine. I have red or rosé.
I wasn't exactly sure why Amy and Chris decided to sit in the same chair.
Maybe she did not want to sit next to me.
Yeah, maybe.
I didn't take it personally.
It was slightly funny.
I almost went and sat on his lap just so we would be even. So tell us about wedding. Where are you guys out at the wedding?
We've got the music almost worked out. You know, I'm pretty much letting Amy handle almost everything else. But
oh, really? Yeah. Now, are you going to see each other?
No, I chose not to.
Very nice.
I'm very much a traditional, you know, kind of person. Nice. So, yeah, no, he's not going to see me until I walk down.
Oh.
To hell with tradition.
Nope. It does feel a little surreal being in the same room with my fiance, talking to Matt, having, you know, his longtime relationship there with Caryl, and talking about our wedding on the farm.
Well, I'm sure it'll be lovely and the weather will be lovely. I'm glad you guys chose the farm.
After the divorce became final, I figured, see ya. I would not imagine sitting in the same room with him talking about my wedding to my fiance.
What do you guys think of Jackson's first week of school?
I think it's good for him, especially if he's going to go into more school next year.
And having a little structure.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Jackson's going to a place at school that he doesn't know these kids, right? Mm-hmm. They don't know him, he doesn't know them. Yeah. Do you remember an age with your guys' kids of when, like, when Zachary realized, like, oh, I'm different?
I would have to say it was probably more kindergarten.
Jeremy and Zachary is a little different because they were twins, and Jeremy was tall and Zachary small. There was an early comparison. You know, that made a little tougher because there was no excuses. There was just like, you know, this is my life, and this is what my life would be if I didn't have this dwarfism. So Zach kind of had that comparison just constantly staring at him in the face.
Well, getting back to the Jackson thing in the school, I was curious because the other day I saw him, I hadn't seen him in a couple of days, and I said, oh, you know, in usual fashion, you're getting so big. And he said, yes, I'm getting big and I'm gonna be big and tall like mommy.
Oh, no.
But it started that
thing. So they haven't had that conversation.
They never do.
Well, the thing that I usually said to kids, I said, yeah, you will be bigger, but you will be as big as you're supposed to be.
I've never really had a conversation with Amy heart to heart about her grandchildren and little people-ness. And so it was good to kind of get, you know, have those conversations where she's able to share some of the things that was her and Matt's life. And it was interesting.
Well, you know, when I first met when I first met Chris.
That happens now and then.
Well, we're in a room.
I'm not listening.
Luckily, I don't call him Chris. Okay.
That, not at the wrong time.
Anyway, that rarely happens. Don't be giving them the wrong impression.
When Amy called Chris Matt, I almost died because there's definitely been a handful of times that he's called me Amy. It probably wasn't Amy's first choice to come over and see my deck, but I give her a lot of credit. She's making those steps, and we're all working toward healthy. So these little times where we just get together and it's light, it sort of lays a foundation for future visits that it's not awkward anymore. So I think it went really well, actually.
What's really good is Caryl keeps me really even keeled, and I think Chris keeps Amy even keeled. So everybody's on their best behavior.
Well, thanks, guys.
Yeah. Thanks for stopping by.
I think it'll always be rare for the four of us to get together. But I'm glad that we can do that when we need to or whatever the occasion may arise.
You know, interesting topics. I thought we had a good talk.
Yeah, so did I.
All right, guys, drive safe. I'm sure we'll talk to you soon.
Okay.
All right, take care.
See you.